In this video, I am going to explain anatomy of pec minor. Pec minor is part of shoulder girdle muscles. I'm going to explain its origin, insertion, function, and important anatomical relationship with nervous tissue. Okay, the insertion is this part. It attaches on the rib cage. It's from rib 3-4-5. Rib 3-5. This is origin. Insertion is this part. This is part of scapula. This is coracoid process. Coracoid process. This is very tiny place of scapula, but since this attaches on scapula, this muscle has very important role for scapular movement. So this is origin, rib 3-5, and this is insertion, coracoid process. Now let me explain movement of pec minor. So let's imagine scapula is like this on the posterior part of the body. Because pec minor is on the anterior part of the body, it's very hard to imagine the movement of scapula. So let's imagine scapula is like this. What happens if pec minor contracts? It brings scapula this way, right? This direction. This movement brings scapula downward. This is depression. Depression, and it makes kind of a rotational movement this way. This is downward rotation. Downward rotation. Okay, depression, downward rotation, and many more movements. It brings scapula outward. This is abduction of scapula. Abduction. Okay, depression, downward rotation, and abduction. These movements are very important for shoulder movement as well, because shoulder joint doesn't accomplish all the shoulder movement by itself. You know, scapula needs to move together with shoulder joint. If scapula does not move, shoulder cannot move. So these movements are very important to assist shoulder movement. Okay, so depression brings scapula down. Downward rotation brings scapula this way. And abduction brings scapula outward. And I'd like to explain one more minor movement. Okay, now you are looking scapula and pec minor from profile view. This is pec minor. And this is scapula, of course. If pec minor pulls scapula this way, what kind of movement does happen? It brings scapula kind of this way. Right? Because pec minor is putting scapula this way, so it makes kind of a rotational movement for anterior way. What is this movement? I have never heard this movement, but let's say this is anterior rotation of scapula. Let's say this inferior angle comes posterior this way because of the direction of pec minor. You know, this is relatively posterior from this part, right? So there is kind of a diagonal vector, right? This vector brings scapula moves forward, right? This is also very important for scapula movement and also the shoulder movement. Oh my gosh, pec minor has so many things to do for scapula. And shoulder. It doesn't attach on the humerus, that's why it is not shoulder muscle. However, it has effect for shoulder indirectly. This is very, very important muscle. Now, in this part, I'd like to explain relationship with nervous tissue. You see these yellow tissues? This is brachial plexus. Brachial plexus is a bundle of nervous tissue. These guys go to shoulder. These guys go to axilla here. And these guys go to the upper arm, forearm, wrist, fingers. Basically, everywhere on the upper limb. Now, this brachial plexus passes posterior to pec minor. This part, you see that? Now, what happens if pec minor gets tight? You know, this gets tight, inhibited. Don't you think the brachial plexus is also inhibited or got impingement? Yes, that could happen. Pec minor can get tight very easily because of the repetitive movement of scapula, because of the long time posture, fixed posture. Pec minor can get tight. Now, there is brachial plexus posterior to pec minor, let's say this one. If this part gets tight, that can affect brachial plexus. Now, you might have pain around here. That can be thoracic outlet syndrome. Thoracic outlet syndrome is the people have pain around anterior shoulder and around clavicle, around the anterior thorax. This is very, very common place. So functionally or clinically, pec minor is very important muscle, okay? So I hope this video helps your understanding of anatomy. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.